Now let's talk about the velocity of propagation, or how fast the wave propagates. Velocity of propagation is sometimes also called VOP. You'll see that in some abbreviations. The velocity of propagation is, here is a wave. Let's pretend it's a wave in the ocean, and that I'm standing right here on the top of this wave. So there I am, standing on top of the wave. If I'm in a little boat and the wave is moving, and this is time, you would see me move over here. So at time t1, I would be here on the left. At time t2, I would be there on the right. The velocity of propagation is going to tell me how fast I move from the left to the right as the wave moves. And at all times, I'm staying exactly here on the crest of the wave. So the way it works is that is the phase of the wave, let's calculate this. The phase of the wave is the part that's right here inside the cosine omega t minus beta x plus phi term. This whole thing is the phase of that cosine. That's the phase of the wave, and that is constant. The phase of the wave is constant. And that can be found as omega t minus beta x plus phi. And the way I do that is I take the time derivative. So I'm going to take d by dt of my phase, omega t minus beta x plus phi. And what that's going to give me is omega, that's this first derivative, minus beta derivative of x with respect to time, plus 0, because the derivative with respect to time of phi is 0. And that leaves me with dx by dt is omega divided by beta. Now dx by dt is velocity. That is a change in meters per change in time. So this is given in meters per second. And this is the velocity of propagation. Your book uses VP, or it's VOP. Sometimes they use mu P or mu P. This is the velocity of propagation, and it tells me how fast the peak of my wave is going to be traveling. Now let's look at lead and lag. When I write cosine of omega t minus beta x plus phi, this phase right there, the phi term, is going to tell me whether my wave leads or lags. So right here is my original wave, the dark blue, and that's where this value phi is equal to 0. So if phi is equal to 0, that's my original wave. Now a wave lags if it happens later. So right here, this black wave is lagging because it occurs later. And that happens whenever my phi is negative. Then I lag my original wave. If my phi is positive, then I'm going to lead. Let's take a look at a leading wave. This wave right here, the light blue wave, that wave is leading my reference wave. And that's what happens when my phase is positive. Now we have one other very interesting factor to look at here, and that is the attenuation of the wave. We wrote the original magnitude as a function of space and time as A cosine of omega t minus beta x plus phi. But if a wave is in a material that has conductivity, that wave is going to be lossy. What it's going to do is give up some of its energy to the material that's around it. If you want to bake a potato, you want to be able to have a significant attenuation of that wave inside your potato. It's like taking your electrical wave, depositing the energy in the potato. So the way we describe how the magnitude of this wave changes as it gives off some of its energy to the surroundings is we use an exponential factor, and that is e to the minus alpha x. X is still our distance. Here's x over here. And the alpha is the attenuation constant, and its units are nepers per meter. A neper doesn't mean anything. It's just like saying per meter, and neper is just a way of giving Mr. Neper a little pat on the back. So right here, this is our alpha, which is 0.2, and here's our x value.